Good morning. Let's do two center of mass multiple choice problems to review for the AP Physics 1 exam. This is a part of my AP Physics 1 Ultimate Review Packet, so please consider signing up at ultimatereviewpacket.com for the full review.
Flippin' Physics!
Bo, please read this one.
Question 1. A giant spherical helium balloon with mass capital M and radius capital R has a massless rope of length 3 capital R hanging from it. A person with a mass of capital M is hanging on the rope in perfect equilibrium such that the balloon person system does not move up or down. If the person starts a distance capital R from the bottom of the balloon and climbs down to the end of the rope, which figure best illustrates the final position of the balloon and person? Assume there is no wind. Gotta love this question. Spherical balloon, massless rope, floating in equilibrium, no wind. I mean, really, that is a lot of assumptions. I don't think this question is realistic at all.
Valid point, Bo. You will likely run into questions on the AP Physics 1 exam which are not realistically possible in the world we live in. However, in order to allow you to demonstrate your understanding of the physics principles, sometimes we do have to step into an ideal world. Please get used to it.
Sure, Mr. P.
Billy, please solve this problem.
Absolutely. Well, because the net external force acting on the balloon person's system equals zero, the acceleration of the system will also be zero. And because the system is at rest to begin with, the system will stay at rest relative to the Earth the whole time. That means the center of mass of the balloon person's system will stay in the same location relative to the Earth while the person climbs down to the bottom of the rope. We need to figure out where the center of mass of the system is before the person starts climbing down the rope and after the person reaches the bottom of the rope. Because both objects have the same mass, the initial center of mass of the balloon person's system will be directly in the middle between the centers of mass of the two objects. In other words, because the initial distance between the two objects is 2 times capital R, the initial center of mass of the balloon person's system will be half that distance, or a distance of capital R, from the centers of mass of both objects. Again, because both objects have the same mass, the final center of mass of the balloon person's system will again be in the middle between the centers of mass of the two objects. In other words, because the final distance between the two objects is 4 times capital R, the final center of mass of the balloon person's system will be half that distance, or a distance 2 times capital R, from the centers of mass of both objects. In other words, as the person climbs down the rope, the center of mass of the system will move from being a distance of capital R below the center of mass of the balloon to a distance of 2 times capital R below the center of mass of the balloon. However, the center of mass of the balloon person's system always stays in the same place relative to the Earth. Therefore, the correct answer choice is B.
What about the rope? Doesn't the rope affect where the center of mass of the balloon person's system is?
It says in the problem that the rope has no mass, so no, the rope does not affect where the center of mass of the balloon person is.
Right. I forgot. Massless rope. Sure.
Well done, Billy. Bobby, please read the next question.
Question 2. While peacefully reading your physics textbook, you are sliding at 3 meters per second east on a very large patch of frozen frictionless ice.
Yeah. Frictionless ice.
Yes, Bo. Frictionless ice. Bobby?
In frustration, you decide to throw your physics textbook and give it a speed of 8 meters per second north. If your mass is 40 times larger than the mass of your physics textbook, what is the velocity of the center of mass of the U textbook system after you throw the book?
Bo, please solve this one.
Well, throwing your book while sliding on frictionless ice is a physics explosion with zero net external force on the book U system. So linear momentum of the book U system is conserved. That means the sum of the initial momentum of the system equals the sum of the final momentum of the system. Initially, you are holding the book, so the initial momentum of the system is the mass of the book plus the mass of U, all times the initial velocity of the book, of U and the book. The final momentum of the system is the sum of the momenta of the book and U. So the mass of the book times the velocity final of the book plus the mass of U times the final velocity of U. We know the initial velocity of the system is 3 meters per second east. The final velocity of the book is 8 meters per second north. And the mass of you equals 40 times the mass of the book. Oh, this is getting pretty complicated. We actually need to look at the X and Y directions for this problem. I thought the AP Physics 1 exam did not have us solving two-dimensional conservation of momentum problems. I thought we were only responsible for one-dimensional conservation of momentum problems.
The answer is 3 meters per second east, right? Answer B.
Why?
Because the net force on the system during the explosion is zero, so the acceleration of the system during the explosion is zero, and the system maintains a constant velocity, so the velocity of the center of mass of the system is the same before and after you throw the book.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right. These two center of mass questions are actually quite similar. Both involve zero net external force on the system, therefore each system has zero acceleration. For the first question, the center of mass of the system initially is at rest, so it stays at rest in the same location. For the second question, the center of mass of the system maintained a constant velocity. Again, zero net external force on the system means zero acceleration of the center of mass of the system. If you find yourself starting to work out an algebraically complicated multiple choice problem, I suggest you pause and take a few moments to see if there is an easier solution. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.